Whenever you're watching any kind of tutorial, it's always about some kind of fundamental logical structure that you should be following to improve your skill, be it some knowledge about anatomy of a body part or about how you should be shading objects. But when it actually comes to painting or drawing, what you mostly do is just taking this countless amount of tiny silent decisions that are really hard to sort of share or talk about. And today I want to talk about one of them that I sort of came across while painting, and I thought I need to share this. I call it adding a floating one. It's a working title, but the idea is the following. Whenever we're painting something, I sort of try to paint at a lower skill level, I don't know, but like in here, this is like a basic idea, right? Just a floating piece of soil with some grass on top. And generally it's looking fine, but there is a certain dimension missing that would be connecting this solid object with the canvas in general. And I think what helps with doing that is literally adding floating elements. The best example of applying this is usually about grass or hair or any kind of like clutter where you have a lot of details and they're all sort of stuck together in one way or another. Yet instead of just painting them like this in one giant piece, you actually go with this kind of approach. Now, I worked a lot more on this piece than on this one, so I'm not trying to convince you by just painting something better, but the main interesting part about this version comparing to this one is that it has these floating bits everywhere. And I even applied that to the soil a little bit, even though it doesn't really make sense. Same as with the grass. Like, it's not a grass that is falling apart or that has some kind of green flies flying around. Yet I'm intentionally adding these floating bits. And that's something I notice whenever I do a paint over or whatever, that pretty much never happens in the submissions. And it's the kind of little feature that you apply in your brushwork that really helps sort of dive the object into the three-dimensional space and into like the sub-sampling effect of the brushwork. I also painted a bit of hair and also did these floating hairs in here and there. There are countless reasons why this can happen. First of all, the hair might catch like a highlight, so it's blending with the background because it's the same color, like just white highlight. Or another reason that I really find like the main one, the fact that not a single detail is obligated to perfectly align with your brush. And there's a lot to unfold there, but the point is, whenever you're painting a single hair, you're doing a great mistake, because hairs are a lot smaller than any brush size you can ever select. It's literally, in most cases in this situation, the hair is smaller than 1 pixel. You're physically unable to select that kind of size. So you don't even try to do that. What you're doing instead, you're painting masses of hairs. And whenever they get thin enough, sometimes they may disappear, and you sort of have to live in comfort with that idea and constantly let your details disappear here and there. So yeah, aside from just adding a lot of dynamics to the picture, it really feels dynamic when you add floating details comparing to this. It's also actually physically and logically accurate to do that for the photo effect reasons of highlights and just out of focus effects, and for the whole brushwork idea. That's just to name a few. There's more reasons why this may happen, but these are the few that should be enough. So yeah, add a floating one. I think it's an idea worth giving a try. Bye!